Here, I have used my overlocker and cover stitch machine to create my boxy workout top. Cover stitch on the armholes, the neckline, and also the hem, and overlocking on the side and the shoulder seam. Although more and more sewers are buying overlockers, a cover stitch machine is more for the professional seamstress. You don't need either to make great jersey garments. Here is the jersey body pattern made up, and as you can see, I have used conventional sewing machine methods throughout. The seams are stitched with a very slight zigzag to give some stretch. The seam allowance is trimmed back to about a quarter of an inch, then pressed open. You can also press it to the side, as it is sometimes fiddly to press open. The edges are simply folded to the wrong side and stitched with two rows of straight stitching and then trimmed. I shall be showing you how best to do this. Accuracy with spacing of the lines of stitches makes all the difference. This pretty skirt is an example of good use of the sewing machine on jersey. I used this clever strip shearing elastic to make the easiest of waistbands. It's a great invention. The contrast band is top-stitched in place. What a lovely colour combination. Even though the jerseys are quite different, they work well together. The hem again, mimicking the cover stitch, is simply machined around twice and trimmed. So neat. A quick look at the inside. I used traditional shearing elastic in my bobbin case to gather the skirt before sewing to the trimming band. A great trick for quick gathering. And the side seams were stitched with a narrow zigzag, trimmed and pressed open or to one side. Jersey is so versatile, and it really comes into its own when combined with other fabrics, such as an easy finish to a neckline. A stand collar will always be cool and sophisticated, even with these homely fabrics. I used an overlocker in this case, but simple straight stitch achieves the same effect. The patch pockets are simply top-stitched in place. I sewed the gathered skirt to the jersey shift, but I could have easily made it a separate garment. An afterthought, which I will do next time. I attached my wide shearing elastic to gather the shift at waist level, ran gathering thread around the gingham skirt and zigzagged it in place. The hem is cover stitched, but again could be stitched with two rows of machining or twin needle stitching, a technique coming up next, then trimmed. Let's take a close look at this menswear vest. Another way to imitate cover stitch is to use a twin needle. For best results, use woolly nylon in the bobbin, which is slightly stretchy. With a twin needle, you see two rows of machine stitching on the right side and a crisscross stitch beneath, very similar, in fact, to commercial cover stitch. You get these needles in various widths. Experiment. You may find you need to loosen the bobbin tension a little. So that is the hem taken care of. I used an overlocker for the side seams, but I could easily have used my sewing machine. This time I self-bound the neckline and armhole, finishing again with twin needle stitching. This is a quality finish for sleeveless garments in general. I use it on top-range dresses and tops. It is easy though, and I will be covering the process in a future tutorial. I have had many requests to include patterns for menswear on my website. Impress your friends and make some cool t-shirts.